Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to provide a high-level overview of AlphaSOC and describe our system architecture and really dig into and demonstrate why hundreds of security teams choose to use our software to augment and provide greater visibility from a SOC kind of analysis and threat hunting perspective. So virtually all of our customers, if not all of them, have, they already have a SIM, they already have SOAR orchestration systems in place, they already have threat feeds they're consuming, threat intelligence that they're doing, and a lot of work and one-dimensional correlation that's happening continuously against the data sets. The reason that they choose to use our software is from an additive perspective. We then allow those teams to flag emerging threats, threats without known signatures, and achieve a greater level of visibility over their systems and their networks in particular. One of the best ways to demonstrate that would be to really just dive into our Splunk demo instance here. So here we have just basic C2 alerts that we're generating. We have some Tor traffic we're alerting on in particular. Now, these are use cases that can already be solved natively within Splunk, within Alien, Vault, ArcSight, and other SIM platforms in particular. From a consumer perspective, you would just pull down a threat feed of known C2 destinations or known Tor nodes, and then you would just cross-reference and correlate your data set with that material. Where things then start to get difficult from a use case perspective is identifying emerging threats or anomalies that don't have known signatures. So just in terms of really demonstrating that delta between kind of legacy SIMs and threat feeds and threat intelligence kind of consumption models versus what I would call proper analytics and kind of deeper classification of data is this kind of threat here. So here within the system, we're flagging traffic to a young domain impersonating a known brand. So the system is then smart enough to understand that Amazon AWS EC2.net here, which is just a DNS destination, is then an imposter domain. So it's not using Amazon, it's not registered to Amazon proper. And it's a permutation of a legitimate brand. And on top of that, on the back end within the analytics engine, we're then whoising all of the domains that we see within customer environments. And the system then recognizes here that this domain in particular is less than 60 days old. So it then combines these two features and then upgrades this to a high severity issue for the security team to threat hunt around it in particular. Now, if you're using a legacy SIM, and this kind of traffic was to exist within your environment, you would be blind to it unless you had this FQDM in particular on a threat feed. So practically within customer environments, we've seen red team exercises undertaken before where we've then been able to flag these imposter domains, or even we've seen state-sponsored spear phishing activity where we can then flag this custom infrastructure as it stood up. So that really is a quick example of how the AlphaSOC analytics engine and the work that we're doing in terms of that kind of heavier lifting goes above and beyond your kind of basic one-dimensional correlation with threat feeds. And that really is the whole value proposition here and really the work that we've been doing over the last few years and the way that we kind of add value from a security operations perspective. In terms of the system architecture, this slide here just demonstrates the flow from left to right. So the important thing is to achieve visibility from a network telemetry perspective. In an ideal world, we would want to be seeing DNS query events within an environment. We'd want to be seeing IP connectivity events outbound. So whether those are being collected through Brew IDS or full packet capture, firewall logs in particular. And then finally, we can also then process HTTP egress events as well. So if you're capturing web proxy logs through Zscaler, Bluecoat, these types of systems, ideally you would get that material up into a kind of aggregation layer, whether it's Splunk, Elastic, or you can use our open source agent, which is a very lightweight piece of software we put together called Network Flight Recorder. These three tools on the left-hand side of this diagram then allow you to aggregate the material and the telemetry, ship it into the analytics engine, which can be run either or consumed as a cloud service or run on-prem. The cloud service runs up in Google Cloud. The on-prem version is just a single Linux binary that we distribute that's very easy to get to set up within a container or a Linux VM within your environment. And then on the right-hand side here, we have the escalation, alert escalation paths. These three here are just native escalations. So we have a Splunk app within Splunk base. We have a native integration for Demisto. And then we're in the Greylog marketplace as well. So these are basically plug and play, extremely straightforward to set up integrations. We can escalate the alerts off to any SIM or SOAR platform. The way that we do this is through Network Flight Recorder. So bottom left here, we have NFR. NFR can also then pull down alerts from the API in JSON format and then ship them in CEF, common event format, out to ArcSight or QRadar or Alien Vault, whichever SIM or SOAR platform you're using. We can ship that material via syslog into a collector and then get that into your, you know, legacy SIM software as well. So that, you know, hopefully that gives you an idea of the architecture and the way that you could consume our service and get data into the engine for scoring and then escalate the alerts. The final thing to just dig into, if I jump back here into Safari, I just, you know, just showing the ease of, you know, deploying some of these integrations. So here is our GitHub page for NFR. So if you were to just browse to github.com/AlphaSOC/NFR, here we have the Network Flight Recorder documentation. And then natively here within NFR, you can then register and generate an evaluation API key, which is then completely free and unrestricted to use for 30 days. And also within NFR, you can then either have it sniffing, set up as a sniffer, monitoring traffic on a given interface, or you can pick up Bro IDS or other log files and monitor material that you may have on disk that's come in through other systems or means, whether you're using Suricata, Bro IDS, whatever the kind of telemetry source is. If I then click into the second tab, we then have the Network Behavior Analytics for Splunk application. This then is a Splunk app that can both pick up telemetry, score it via the engine, and then render the various alerts and provide some very rich dashboards. This app is free to download from Splunkbase, and then once you then run the app, it will then generate an API key that again is free and unrestricted to use for 30 days. I've actually put together a 30-minute video that really digs into Network Behavior Analytics for Splunk in particular. You'll find it on the YouTube channel, and it just goes through then, you know, product setup, getting the data into Network Behavior Analytics for Splunk to then score, and then how to then use the alerts and you know, integrate with Splunk ES and some of these other kind of more advanced topics as well. Moving on into the next tab here, this then is the page for Elastic Packet Beat. So if you're using Elastic within your environment and you have Packet Beat set up to then you know, pick up data and network telemetry on the wire, we can then give you a config that will ship material natively from Packet Beat straight into our API for scoring. And then you can then pull down those alerts, as I had mentioned, either in CEF or JSON format, you know, throw them back into Kibana, deploy Greylog 2. There are lots of different ways to then consume the alerts as well. And that was really what I wanted to kind of give you a quick overview of today. So hopefully that's been useful from an architecture perspective. Again, with this diagram here, these aren't an exhaustive list of integrations. These are just the native integrations that are very easy to get up and running with. If you run into any challenges or problems with these, feel free to reach out to us at support@alphasoc.com, and I look forward to catching up with you next time. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Bye.